She's not fracking for oil, but for steam. She's vice president of strategy for Fervo Energy, a Houston-based company focused on what's called enhanced geothermal.
You need steam, spin a turbine, create electricity.
Gabe Malik is chief of staff at Fervo Energy. He says in traditional geothermal, only certain parts of the world have the right kind of permeable rock and heat that can make enough steam for successful production.
We're using technology that allows us to create that steam in completely new locations by accessing hot rock and pumping water through that hot rock and bringing it back to the surface.
Malik says Fervo's use of oil and gas technology to drill and fracture rock underground makes geothermal cheaper and more feasible in more places. And that could be a game changer since, unlike wind or solar, geothermal is considered firm, clean energy. Sarah Jewett again.
These renewable energies that are, you know, not intermittent and not dependent on the weather, but that are producing all the time.
The company has started construction on a 400-megawatt geothermal project in southwest Utah, with more projects on the horizon.
There's so much demand for firm, clean energy, and so we basically, at this point in time, feel like we can't build fast enough to meet the demand.
And Fervo is just one horse in this race.
In a changing energy world, we're very focused here in Houston on making sure that 10 years from now and 20 years from now and 40 years from now, Houston continues to be the energy capital of the world.
To stay a global leader, Bobby Tudor of investment firm Artemis Energy Partners says Houston needs to think beyond fossil fuels. And investment is growing. According to the Greater Houston Partnership, Houston-based energy transition firm secured $6.1 billion in financing from investors last year. That's up 62%. Tudor says he's particularly interested in Houston's role in storing and delivering clean hydrogen.
60% of the nation's dedicated hydrogen pipelines, are in Greater Houston, Texas. 60%. So we have fantastic infrastructure.
That said, pressure to transition to clean energy in Texas comes at a time when the state is just trying to keep up with peak demand as extreme temperatures and a growing population strain the electric grid. While wind and solar have played an important role in keeping the AC blowing this summer.
We are short baseload capacity in Texas right now, so we're going to build a bunch of new natural gas-fired plants because that baseload capacity cannot currently be met with wind, solar, and batteries.
Tudor says just to meet growing electricity demand in the state, fossil fuels will continue to play a major role for now as Houston competes to remain an energy capital. In Houston, I'm Elizabeth Trovall for Marketplace.
Final note on the way out today, a glimmer of hope for renters out there. Saw this on CNBC. There's a real estate technology company called RealPage, which is out with some interesting data. The company says rents in August this year were up just 0.28% from August a year ago, while rents a year ago were rising at an 11% annual clip. And the company points out rents are actually due for a big drop because the number of new rental units being built is at a 50-year high, 460,000 of them just this year.
Marketplace is supported by McDermott, Will, and Emery, an international firm where lawyers work every day to help clients fuel missions, knock down barriers, and shape markets. More at MWE.com. And by JLL, a leasing, management, investment, and technology company dedicated to creating a brighter future for the world of commercial real estate. JLL.com. See a brighter way.
All right, we are out of here on a Friday. Not, of course, without your moment of economic context. The common refrain the past year or so has been that Americans are gloomy about the macro economy, but feeling pretty good about their own situations. Here is one possible reason why. The Federal Reserve released some new data today that shows household net worth hit a record last quarter, up 3.7% to $154.3 trillion. That is mostly on real estate and stock market gains. You, astute listener, will rightly point out that there is a big chunk of the population of this country that has neither real estate nor stock market holdings. Our theme music was composed by BJ Lederman. Marketplace's executive producer is Nancy Fargali. Donna Tam is the executive editor. Neil Scarborough is the vice president and general manager. I'm Kai Rizdahl. We will see you Monday, everybody. This is APM.
Support for WNYC comes from